Chances are, if you love to ink blend, you've probably been asking yourself, what is the big deal with the oval makeup brushes? Well, the whole point of today's video is to do a direct comparison of these four brushes, and actually one other, to see the difference of whether or not the life-changing brushes are worth 50 bucks, or can you spend 13 or 14 on Amazon instead? Hey guys, my name is Ingrid Blackburn, welcome. Because this channel is about teaching you different techniques, I'm gonna show you exactly how I get an effortless blend, as well as give you an honest opinion about each of these brushes and whether or not I think they are worth purchasing. There is the life-changing brush set right here, put out by Picket Fence Studios. These two are by Yoseng, and this is just a brand that I found on Amazon, and this one is by Kedsum. I have been working with the oval makeup brushes for about 6.5 months now. I have used Amazon brands, and I have used life-changing brushes. And this is the actual life-changing set. This is the largest one, and this is an acrylic makeup brush stand that I got off Amazon. It's great for holding these in place if you only have one set. If you have a couple, you can get a couple. I've filmed this video in several parts. I have since received my other set of brushes, which makes my fifth one, which is not exactly what I thought they would be. I thought they would be a little more of the looser type of brush, and they are in fact the tighter type. So I already know how they're going to perform. So I'm feeling that I'll use one, but probably not use the rest just because I kind of know where they're headed. They're going to be very, very similar to this other brand that I have that are both really tight. So they're going to work just fine, but they won't perform as well as the ones that are a little looser. And the rose gold ones, even though in just my experience, they do have a little bit more fatigue on the arm and the hand, they perform beautifully. This one you can see lots and lots of little hairs already coming out, which doesn't seem to affect my blending at all. And then I have this other, the exact same brand, Yoseng, but this one, the ergonomic handle is of course looser. So exact same brush, but look at how different it is. And in my experience, the looser ones are fabulous, just like the life-changing. So you can see here's the complement to this one, or maybe this one is just a little. Here we go. They're not quite exactly the same size. The life-changing brushes tend to be a little different in size. Pretty close. Pretty close. These two are probably the closest, I would say. But quite honestly, I have a feeling they're going to perform very, very similar. I've been using these, as you've seen on my channel, for several months now. And one of the biggest differences between these is actually how tight the little brush hairs are together into the base. Now the Kedsum is completely different from the Yoseng and the Picket Fence Studio, and I found the tightest out of all of them. The Yoseng is relatively open and looser. However, the metallic handle here that does not bend, unlike the other ones that are a little bit more ergonomic, say the Picket Fence Studio, for instance, and the regular, actually a dollar less than this one, this entire 10-piece set, this is actually a little more open. I find it interesting that these two are very similar. I'll be very honest with you. And the biggest difference between them is price point. You have for a set, a complete set, a full set of 10, you have $49.95 or $49.99, I'm not exactly sure. And for this complete set, it's $13.98. So big difference, they all come from China. So the difference here is I don't really know what company this is, and I'm sure that it's a makeup brand. I know it's a Chinese company. I tried to Google it. It got me to a Chinese site. I've actually met the owner of Picket Fence Studios, and she is just completely sweet, and I love supporting small businesses. That being said, you know, I have to also be realistic, and, you know, when you're really into the craft and you love to ink blend, or say, you know, you kind of got into the Ranger ink tools, as I have a lot. You know, I can't afford, you know, 5-6 sets of these. Now, she actually graciously gave me this set at Creativation this year, which was wonderful, and I've really loved using it and can't speak highly enough about this particular set. You know, but that being said, again, funds are funds. So I'm going to get into the nitty gritty between these. You can see that they're just slightly different. This one comes down a little bit more in size. I did see that at the base, they're attached a little differently. So I can't say that they are identical, because where this actually meets, this piece meets this. And I don't know if that's just this particular set or if they are in fact different. She's told me that hers were designed for her as she suffers from, I can't believe, I'm not sure if it's arthritis or some sort of a, you know, hand, something that affects her being able to hold everything. This is actually attached much closer to the hairs. And she's also told us that this is actually made out of plastic fibers, whereas these are not always, that's not always the case here. Now, to the touch, they don't feel much different, but that doesn't mean that they aren't. I can't speak to that. They perform, to me, very similar. These, I found, have a tendency to give off the hairs a lot quicker. It does not affect my blending, I'll be very honest, so it's not bothering me. I've been using these a lot, as you can tell, by my brushes, and these have been washed several times. But they are the hairs are starting to come up. So just, you know, just so you're aware of those differences. One of the things that's nice about the Picket Fence Studio brushes, since the hairs are a bit looser, my wrist and my hand don't tire as easily. I will say that probably my most favorite size is this very small one, which comes in the 6-piece set or the full 10. I do like this one, but I tend to favor some of the smaller size brushes. I find that when I am ink blending, I don't really need this huge a piece unless I'm covering an entire sky. I am finding more and more uses for this set. So if you originally thought, oh, I'm never going to use that, this is my most used brush right here, because I love to do corners and I love to do vignettes on my pieces to help draw the viewer in. And when it comes to stencil work, if you think that you're going to be using any stencils, these 6 can be very valuable. If you're into scenic stamping, these 3 right here, they will be used, as well as this dome piece right here. So just to kind of give you some sort of an overview, this video is going to be chock full of tips, along with different ways of using your brushes, as well as side-by-side comparison. I do find that it performs very similarly to the Picket Fence Studios. This is its sister brush, just with a different handle, making it just slightly more compact. And this one does give me a little bit more flexibility because it is an ergonomic versus this being a little bit more, you know, solid. And I do find that the solid, although I was drawn to it initially, I do find that I do prefer the ergonomic and the flexibility. You just have to get used to it. But I like this a little bit more because as you are ink blending, you'll find that you're actually using, you know, the brush a lot. And so that actually does come into play in your wrist and your hand tiring over time. So let's jump right in. So I've got a piece of paper here, and I've got several distress inks. You can use Catherine Pooler inks as well. Those are my 2 go-to inks for ink blending. Of course, you can use any of your favorite inks that you have. Start with one of the, we'll start with the start markers. And just kind of get some ink going. What I do love about having lots of different types of brushes is, you know, I can really dedicate them to some color families, which can be very helpful, I find. We're just gonna kind of create a fun little background here. I have a tendency to hold my brush a couple different ways. You can see right now, this was just very natural, me putting my finger right there. But notice I am starting off my project, ending off my project, I do find you still kind of need to adhere to those basic rules, you know, when doing this. Or it's good practice too, I should say. You don't have to. But, you know, if I'm going to start in the middle, I'm obviously going to put the most color right there and it'll leave some weird mark. But I do love these brushes for actual coverage. And we're going to go ahead and speed some of this up a little. Very beautiful, effortless. You have that really nice kind of, you know, fade out. That's what I love about these brushes. So I'm going to switch really quickly now to the Yosang. And I'm going to also switch colors to mustard seed. Clearly I've re-inked this pad. Let's see by the amount of ink right there. The amount of ink I got on my finger too. Which is fine because yellow, this is going to be one that's going to get blended quite a bit. Going to need to kind of get rid of the yellow here. Do a little more blending. I'll make sure that this is dry. I don't want the water to get onto that. And we're going to add a little more green. I think I... Oh, that was the right one. And I have a feeling that this is going to create a deeper green. This is also a relatively yellowish green to begin with, Twisted Citron. It's just a beautiful, beautiful shade. So far, you know what? This one is, it's the tighter version, not quite so loose. And I find that I'm tiring already. And the yellow, I probably didn't need to do that, but much looser. Makes it easier to actually hold. And let's go ahead and use a life-changing. I know I've used this for other colors, but I'm gonna go ahead and we'll just cut that part off, no big deal. This is the life-changing brush, and this feels very similar to the other one that I was just using. I think I want this to be brighter. This is not working for me. It's not bright enough. I want Salty Ocean. So let's move into Salty Ocean. Bring in the brightness. It's going to create some fun little green. You can see where that yellow is. Creating kind of like an emerald right there, but you can see how much ink it's depositing. And if you want to be a little bit more deliberate, you can also hold your brush like this, although that's providing a little bit more drag on my hand. Just want to get rid of some of this blue because we're going to go back now to the yellow. I still have some yellow on here, and I just want to kind of make that, again, just like when you used to do with the foam brushes, still have a little bit of a blend there. So we'll just kind of blend across to kind of make that a little bit more effortless of a combo here. And let's add a little mermaid lagoon, which is even a little deeper. That's a really cool look. I want to save a little bit of white space here because I'm going to add some purple. So that's a beautiful blend. Again, you're going to go back in with the yellow. Make sure that want that blend. So every time I'm doing this, I'm depositing more and more ink. And I have to say, the difference between these two is, I don't see it. I did feel a difference between this one that's a little more tight. So I would stay away from those kind. Same thing with this. The more you use this, the more it's gonna, I think, be a little bit more of a, what's the word I'm looking for? It's gonna be a little more tiring. So let's add a little purple here. And we're just gonna add this here to the end. You know, at the end of the day, they're all excellent. They are great to ink blend with. I prefer them much more to the actual foams, because if I were to do the foam, I really have to be careful. And I've taught enough classes and I've seen frustration by lots of students using the foams. They are a great way of getting some coverage, but this actually drops more ink in a quicker manner. So if you love doing scenes, that's where I would head. Let's add a lot of purple here. Yeah, this is definitely a little bit harder to use than the ergonomic ones. I gotta say, I mean, I have been a huge fan of the life-changing brushes. Huge fan of the life-changing brushes. I think it's a fabulous product. The black-handled Yoseng, they're pretty equal to me. I don't feel much of a difference between them. They both are great. It's going to go back to, I know the owner of this company. I do not know this company. And I do love that I can buy two of these. I love that I can buy the four largest sizes of these or the six smaller versus an entire package, especially if you need multiples. I believe two of this size, you know, they retail for $12.99. So, you know, it's nice that you can get several sizes that you would actually use. So let's add some more. And I think I'm going to have to label each one with a color family because this just will make it much easier for me. But this is looking pretty good. I'm really enjoying this color blend. Pretty effortless. And that's the whole point, right? It's the entire point. I love blending purple and blue together. It makes the most beautiful shade of indigo. So pretty. And when you add it here to this yellow into the blue, because remember, there's no green here. This is all just the two colors blending together. Just gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous.
So I'm going to speed up this next little section and I'm going to switch over to the ergonomic Yoseng brand of brushes. And you can see I'm adding a little bit of spice marmalade here to the edge. And then I'm going to deposit just a hair of carved pumpkin, which is really bright orange. And I'm going to keep that really to the corners and the very, very, very edge. I'm going to put a little bit of mustard seed back in the middle. I'm trying to fill in some of those gaps a little bit. You can see some of those white spaces. The more you deposit, these are very translucent inks, just like Catherine Pooler inks as well. The more they layer on top of each other. And that's really what makes ink blending so, so beautiful. A little bit of seedless preserves there. Again, that's a Yoseng brush as well, but that's the rose gold. It's a little bit more of a solid brush than the ergonomic handle.
That's very pretty. That's beautiful and very, very effortless. You know what was really great about this is I never had to really worry about making weird marks. I never once even thought about it, and I've been going pretty quick, you know? So, not for nothing, but that's pretty good. I'm enjoying that part. There's a little more freedom in using these versus using the foam brushes. Nice. I like that. Okay, so we'll just kind of a little bit here. And then I'm going to have to come back in with the yellow. And I'm going to need to clean this before doing that. And this is the mustard seed again. And just blend again. Very pretty. Love it. Effortless look. Definitely this one. These are the Yoseng, the ergonomic, the life-changing brushes. These two are my favorite. I cannot distinguish between them, I'll be very honest with you. I would love to tell you that this is a far superior product. I haven't found a difference in use. And I've been using these for about 4 months now. And maybe not quite 4 months. And the hairs do come out faster of this brand, but I am experiencing hair loss in this one as well. So I can't say that that's not going to happen, but I did have noticed that it doesn't happen as fast. So these are supposedly made for paper crafting. These are made for makeup. You're going to have to be the judge. So I hope that helps you in making your decision on what to purchase. Again, great company, life-changing brushes. Love that it's a small business, and I actually know who they are. This is a big company. They're all made in China, so it's all apples to apples. And I hope you found that helpful.
If you want to learn more ways to use these specific brushes, different sizes, and in different types of cards, with stencils, scenic cards, all sorts of fun techniques, click either of those two videos. And if you're interested in any of the supplies, I have all the links listed below. Don't forget to subscribe, and you know what? I'll see you in the next video.